Bonjour et bienvenue dans Taste.
Hello and welcome to Taste, the culinary magazine of Euronews. Today we're in Burgundy in France, a region famous worldwide for its exceptional wines. But we're not here to talk about wine, but a drink which is just as complex, sake. Gauthier Roussil, thank you for welcoming us into your vineyards. You're a winemaker and agronomist. You are also one of the world's sake specialists and author of the reference book, Nihonshu, Japanese Sake. So, tell us more about the unique characteristics of sake.
Hello and welcome. Firstly, what determines the characteristics of sake is its raw material, rice. In the right conditions, a fruit ferments naturally and gives us wine, but this is not the case for cereals. Japanese sake is a pure creation of human genius.
We are now in the tasting cellar of the family winery where Gauthier Roussil is going to explain sake's organic characteristics.
Flavors are perceived by the human being in five main criteria: umami, salty, bitter, and sour. Umami is the taste. It's the tomato sauce that's cooked for a long time. Sake is naturally rich in umami and sweet. It's poorer than wine or beer, especially with acid and bitterness. So sake is naturally perceived as pleasant, positive.
So sake works particularly well with certain foods?
Absolutely, especially with dishes that are difficult to pair with other drinks, such as asparagus, eggs or seafood. On this point in particular, it has been shown that iron is the main element which, when combined with seafood, creates an unpleasant ocean-like aroma. But sake is very poor in iron, so it fits perfectly with all types of seafood.
We're leaving Burgundy to head to Champagne, another world-famous wine region, to meet sake expert Sylvain Huet. Sylvain, you are organising the European Sake Show, the biggest ever event dedicated to sake outside Japan. So are chefs and cooks in Europe becoming more and more interested in sake?
It's important to know that sake goes naturally with the Japanese gastronomy, from where it originated, but all Western cuisine can feel the benefits, whether it's French or Italian, ranging from the bistronomic cuisine to the cuisine of three-star restaurants. Sake not only complements wine, but can allow a real rereading of dishes, some classics, some new.
Chef Arnaud Lallemand, who has three Michelin stars, welcomes us to L'Assiette Champenoise. He is one of the new breed of chefs who likes to combine seafood and sake.
Are you all right? We'll taste, try. You'll make me dream with sake, and I'll try to make you travel with my dishes. Today, we're going to work with some open-sea brown crab from Brittany, boiled at the last moment. It's taken out of the water and gently crumbled with tweezers. We then add a large amount of vegetal element inside, and it's this vegetal element that pairs the seafood perfectly with sake. I still have my bubbly side because I'm from the Champagne region anyway, and I was curious about sake being sparkling. For me, that's a real discovery. Okay, I'm going to put a turnip like that. And after you've got it in your mouth right now, once you've got a little bit of it, go to the sake. It's the turnip that provides the link between the sake and the open sea brown crab with fish soup. It's the prickly turnip, the spicy plant. As if you lay your tongue on a nettle, there the turnip brings the link with the sake that is vegetal too.
Merci Arnaud et campagne.
Campagne,
chef.